Today we are going to discuss the phase diagram of water system. As we discussed in our previous lecture, to study the phase diagram, first of all we have to understand how to calculate the degree of freedom. Why degree of freedom? Because as we know, with the help of degree of freedom, we find the variables like pressure, temperature or concentration on the basis of which different system can be specified. Okay? Like in this phase diagram, we are showing the three phases of water. Water exists in the form of solid, solid is the form of ice. Okay? Exists in the form of liquid, this is your water, and next is your vapor phase, which is your gas. Now, in the three phases, we have to discuss first of all, these phase diagram is divided into different parts. First part is about the lines or curves. You have to see in this diagram, there are different lines like lines O, line OB, line OB, line OC and line OA. Yeah, we can call it curve. First of all, we have to know on which factor, either pressure, either temperature or concentration, this line depends. How we calculate? Look at this line. This curve OB. In this line or curve, you have to know how many phases are exist in this line. This is your solid, this is your gas. In this line, two phases are in equilibrium. Meaning means line OB, two phases are in equilibrium, means solid is in equilibrium with the vapor. Now, with the help of this, we have to calculate the value of F, which is based on the phase rule equation. F is equals to C minus E plus 2. F is your degree of freedom, C is component, and P is your phases. Okay? Now, in this line, along the line, component is how? How many components are there? Only one component. As we know, the composition of ice, composition of water, composition of gas is only one, that is H2O. So component in this case is 1. Phase is 2. Along the line, 2 phases. In this way, degree of freedom here comes is 1, that is system is monovariant. Yani, it means at that time along the line or along the curve, the degree of freedom is 1. It means it depends either on pressure or either on temperature. On the basis of this, we have to calculate for the curve OC, curve OA. Along the lines, we have the degree of freedom is 1. Now for the area. There are three areas. Area B, O, C, area A, O, C and area B, O, A. In this area C, O, B, only how many phases exist? Only one, that is solid. In C, O, A, how many phases? Only one, that is liquid. And along the B, O, A, only one phase, that is vapor. In this way, we have to calculate degree of freedom along the area also. It means F is equals to C minus C plus 2. In the same way, component is 1. Phases, along the area, how many phases? Only 1. So phases is 1. Now, the value of degree of freedom comes 2. It means along the area, from transformation from one phase to other phase takes place on changing of our pressure and temperature both. It means depends on both. Now comes to the third part. Third part is your triple point. Triple point is your O. O is your triple point. In this triple point, all the three phases coexist. It means solid, liquid and gas. Solid is in equilibrium with liquid, is in equilibrium with gas. It means on the basis of this, we have to calculate F is equals to C minus E plus 2. In this case also, component is 1. Phase, all the three phases coexist. Now in this case, the degree of freedom comes 0. It means triple point comes at particular pressure or particular temperature. It means for the triple point, pressure is 4.58 mm of mercury and temperature is 0.0075 degree centigrade. It means system is non-variable. System is non-variant. It means system is not if any. It means at triple point we have not. It comes only at fixed temperature and pressure. If we want to change any one of them, either pressure or the temperature or both, three phases don't coexist. One of the phase will disappear and it will become only two phases. That's why along the triple point system is non-variant.